Hi Aditi, welcome to Levels Cancer and Xenon Correct IO.
Hello, hi.
Yes, it's Divya here from Xenon Correct IO, and this is our Cancer Healing Journey Talks, where we invite speakers who have gone through cancer, maybe as patient, caregiver, or survivor, or warriors like you who have been through this disease and are now inspiring others by sharing their stories. And this is very special and close to our heart because many patients and caregivers have told us that when we listen to others' journey, it inspires us. And being on this journey myself, I feel that when we listen to others' journey, it inspires us and motivates us that when they have been through so much and came out of it, then we can too. So thank you for joining us. Thank you for giving your time. It's an honor to have you with us. Could you please introduce yourself and share your journey with us?
Yeah, surely. So, myself, I am Kumar Singh. So, I belong from Ranchi, Jharkhand.
Okay.
So, it's about my mother. She was, it was in the year around 2017, around the month of, in the month of November, because of the excessive bleeding. Like initially also there was some bleeding, like she actually it was detected to be a uterus cancer later.
Okay.
So we had no idea. We had no idea like what was there. Like even I was in my college, like in my second, third year, my elder sister, she was into professional world. Like she was into jobs. So we didn't know. We have no idea about this. So as a like small middle class family, so it was like for us to like go to some consult some normal doctor. So similarly things happened, and this thing got postponed. So finally, in the month of November, which is in the year of 2017, so 2017 we got like on consultation with our relatives who are residing in Mumbai. So they were like, please bring her to Mumbai. We'll just get the test, the biopsy test, which is done. So to detect whether she has cancer or not. So it was done around November, around 14th of November. So my family went to Mumbai and the result came around 19th of November that she has uterus cancer. The stage was like around, I'm not sure, but stage three. That's what I remember. Like, it was the stage three. So she went into, like there was in the shortest span, although there wasn't availability of like beds or anything. So doctor, with the cooperation, we started within the shortest time. She got like accepted as a patient at Mumbai Hospital, like at Tata's Hospital. So then initially she was given chemotherapy was given to her, radiation. This was the first phase. Then second phase was given to her simultaneous chemotherapy and radiation for almost 1 month. In the month of February 2018, this was a treatment of 1 month. So was given, and then it's very obvious to accept the fact that her health deteriorated over the time a lot. So but it was a positive sign that she was able to she was very much she had very strong willpower. So she continued with like throughout the February her treatment got over. Then after 1 month she underwent the another test. The test, like doctor, they did some CT scan was done.
Okay.
So to detect like does she has any cells in her body. So it was a full body CT scan was done. So once it was done, then doctor was like she can take rest for around 2-3 months in Mumbai itself. So during this tenure she stayed there. After 3 months another test was done to detect whether these cells which have been treated are they active or any active cells are there. So the result was like it's okay, she can now with some minor vitamins or so she was asked to, she can go back to the place, our hometown, that is Ranchi. So we came back and then after 6 months, the schedule was, she has to report every 6 months. So 6 months, like around 8, means around August, similarly this month in 2018, they again went to Mumbai. Then the treatment was similar, like she, and the test was done to detect whether any cells are active or not. So it was found okay. Till then, there weren't any cells. So so then under the supervision, the same thing was there. For dietary problems, she couldn't digest because of chemotherapy. So we continued with the one thing was there. We followed one thing that was to give her Naril Pani every day. So coconut water was given to her throughout, like since November, because during her treatment for 1 month, when she was being given radiotherapy and chemotherapy simultaneously on the alternative days, she couldn't digest food. She was only completely on water diet. So sorry, just liquid diet. So we preferred coconut. So it sustained her a lot. So consequently, for every then chemotherapy. Then they said that because they found that there may be some cells which are active in other part of body. So again they went for the CT scan. The result was like they found some active cells in her lungs.
Oh.
That was around 8 months from February, which is around October. Around October when the test was done again. So after the meeting with all the medical team, they decided to give her targeted chemotherapy. Targeted chemotherapy was planned. So targeted chemotherapy, because this was a new trial, so they approached us. It's very common in this patient procedure that the doctor asked us to sign the acceptance.
Yes.
So I think you people might be very much aware about this thing. So in that case also, because this being the new medication in India, so they asked us to sign this. So no issues, we signed it, and then her chemotherapy started. So she continued in Mumbai till 2019 till January.
Okay.
So this was the plan under which she, for every 15 days, once in a 15 days, she was given a targeted chemotherapy.
Okay.
So suppose today, then after 2 weeks again she will be given. So it continued for 1 month. Around 4 weeks she went. Again, doctor was like, because there haven't been much changes in the cells, because maybe the cells have been, it wasn't so effective. So they planned to increase the strength via more concentrated medicine in the targeted this thing. So but they were like, her body is not so strong, because already we have been given her treatment past 1 month. So they directed us to go to our home place, give her proper diet, light foods, which include the most of the fruits, fibrous fruits, and normal. None. They asked us to avoid any spices, like not to give her much of the spices, and avoid any burn or cut in her body. And I would like to mention one thing, that during her treatment, she was able to walk. She was able to, her daily routine includes she used to get up early, like around some 6:30, 7. This was her everyday routine. At night, she used to sleep by similarly 8:30. And evening, she used to go for a walk. So till here, her body was supporting her. So it was fine till then. Then in the month of January, we came back. We camped. Although I was in college, so my family came back to Ranchi. So they stayed there. They stayed there for 2 to 3 months. So around in the month of, my college got over, which is around May 2019. So doctor was like, you guys have to come back again for the another CT scan. We want to see the report, whether your body have recovered, you have enough strength where we can proceed with this thing. Continue the medication. So they went to Mumbai in the month of they are asked for the extension, so around June 2019 they went to Mumbai. So once they were in Mumbai, so again similar thing happened. CT scan was done, full body CT scan was done, and then in that process the doctor found that she has increased cell in her lungs. Oh. In her lungs, so more cell has grown in her lungs, plus there were symptoms of regrowth in the part in which the treatment was given, that is in uterus. Again, there was increment. Plus, there was they speculated that in other parts also, because in the CT scan report there were more darker areas in her body. So they were like, because it seems like it has grown more.
Oh.
So because her body wasn't so much she wasn't, according to doctor, she wasn't healthy, because till that time she used to go with a morning walk. Like morning, I used to go with a morning walk like around. For 30-35 hours, we used to go. Evening again, we used to go. For her, she was normal. But for doctor, she wasn't ready to, body wasn't ready to take the medication. So they planned to give her oral chemotherapy.
Oh.
So in July. So I'm not very specific. I don't remember the name of the tablets which they were giving. Because they said that she, so this 10 years, this medication was around 7 weeks every day tablets, 7 weeks, sorry, 7 days for a week, 7 days tablet, and then for another week, 7 days she will be resting.
Okay.
So alternate. This was a plan which doctor made for 3 months, upcoming 3 months.
Hmm.
But so by that time, so I was there till August. Till August I was there, then I joined my organization. Then she continued with her medication. So by July when they returned, the first week of July when they returned, I was there. So there was one problem which she started facing with the medication. The vomiting. Every evening she used to vomit. Every evening she used to vomit. Once it started, so one thing we observed that with taking this medicine, her body deteriorated extremely fast. Now this was a very critical situation for us, and whether to continue the medicine or not, to reconsult the doctor. So there were many issues, but we continued for almost like 1.5 months. So which means July full, August mid, we continued. And then, so as I mentioned before that I joined my organization. So I wasn't here then they planned to visit doctor in Mumbai. So they were like, fine, continue the medicine. These are the normal side effects which patient suffers from. But we continued with this without. One more thing I want to mention. By this time, we started giving her Giloy also.
Okay.
So Giloy, like we in our home itself, we have like Giloy plant, like it was available. So every morning we used to give her Giloy.
Okay.
Giloy was given to her.
Mm-hmm.
So this continued. Then again in the month of August, almost in the month of September, September, October. Yeah, near to Delhi. Diwali. Sorry. In around Diwali. So she reported that she has reported extreme pain in her head, in the forehead part, in the upper side of the head. So like we were like, maybe because some gas formation, she is facing this problem. Then she was like, it pains a lot in her upper part of the head. Then we continued with the medicine. Then finally we asked, because her body over this period, her body deteriorated. So it was difficult for her. She stopped going for the morning walk, as I mentioned before. And this was a monsoon season. So although she used to walk inside itself, but she couldn't continue to walk for much time. So she, most of the time she was in bed. So this was a scenario September. So this was scenario September. Medicine was continued. She was in bed and we were giving her Giloy. And the pain, she reported pain in her head. Then we continued with the medicine. Then finally we decided that whatever be the condition, we have to go to Mumbai. There is no other option for us. So because that's where her treatment has been going since past almost 2 years. So finally we planned for it. And then my family went to Mumbai, and then we had a doctor again did the CT scan for her. Again, they did the CT scan for her. And then the report suggested that she has overgrown cells in her kidney. In her lungs, and then they reported nodes in more parts in her body. So this includes lungs was there, and then for the head, they didn't do about the head. Then the CT scan again was done for the head, especially. That they found that there are some, they weren't sure whether it's cancerous cell something, but they found something like tumor which was available in her head. Some tumor cells were found. So the report doctor gave, and they were like, it's very difficult to continue the medication. So you can do one thing, take her. And so the doctor actually meant that now no medicine can support her. So they mentioned this in the other way. They mentioned you can take rest, ask her to stay at her home place. So it was a clear indication by doctor that it's very difficult for her to survive in the upcoming months. So finally, we came back to Ranchi without no medicine, with continued pain in her head. And by that time we stopped Giloy also, because that became her very, because she used to feel nauseous because of Giloy also. So vomiting was a major problem that was there, plus weakness, she became extremely weak, her weight started reducing. And then it was very difficult for, then after a few months, because she started reporting a lot of pain in her head, and around Chhat is a Puja, which is celebrated in Bihar region. So near about, she reported one thing that was one of her the eyesight on the left eye. She was unable to see through her left eye because eyesight went. So then because this was very difficult, the pain in her head continued. So we asked. Then we planned. They asked us to whether we have two options, three options, either to stay wherever we are, second to report in the Tata Hospital that is there in Jamshedpur, where they have opened new oncology department has been started. Third, to come back to Mumbai, and they will be looking after it. So we opted for the second one. We went to Jamshedpur also, but Jamshedpur wasn't ready to take her because they were like, we have to do complete biopsy again to know what is the condition because this is a new file. So finally we planned somehow to take her Mumbai. So so around same November, same November we went to Mumbai. I wasn't there, my family went to Mumbai. So we were in Mumbai. So doctor was like, fine, we'll be giving, they started giving her some vitamins thing, and then they asked her to keep her oximeter to check her oxygen level in her body. So this continued till there was no medication which was being given to her. One medicine was added, which was the painkiller. This is like a drug which is given, this drug was given to her. Most of the times she used to sleep after taking this. Hello.
Yes, I can hear you.
Actually, there was, sorry about this, there was a network problem from my side.
Okay.
So, yes, it was around in the month of November. But they went back to Mumbai, and then, yeah, as I mentioned, they gave some drug. I don't remember the name because till this point, I wasn't there. Whatever this mentioned, then around in December, I came back. That was the first time when I saw her in that condition, when her health was extremely down. As I mentioned before, in month of August, she joined my organization. So in this tenure, I didn't see her. I wasn't there.
Okay.
But my family was there. Full family was there. So in December, when I came back, I can describe like she was too thin. Her health came down, and she reported a problem, which I could see. It was unbearable pain in her. One more thing. Around end of November, she couldn't see from both of her eyes. So doctor mentioned that there is an optical nerve which is coming, and that tumor has blocked that nerve. That's the reason why she's unable to see. So it has stopped the blood flow, and that's why she couldn't see. Then finally, there was extreme confusion in my family. It's very obvious. So we had two options, whether to move forward with the medical, which whatever options available for her in a treatment. Second, to let her stay in the same condition till her body recovers. So after too much of confusion, and then finally she insisted a lot to move with the medical problem, because she said she mentions it to be extremely extreme pain was there, unbearable for her over the few months. Then finally we went to the neurological department of Tata. They were like, maybe she has some nerve problem or some tumor problem or brain problem. Then finally they mentioned, that department mentioned that no, she has no, it's not a cancerous cells, and you can move for, it's nothing, it's not a tumor which is growing a lot, so you can move forward with. So file went again to the oncology department. So oncological department suggested at a medical this thing plan, which was to go with the radiation to kill the cells, to kill the cells, so that these cells which are obstructing the optical nerve, if it get released, her eyesight could come back. But it's very obvious that the radiotherapy has their own extreme problems. So this was again a problem for us. And finally on 11th of sorry 6th of January 2020 this year, we went for this treatment, and so we went for this treatment, and she couldn't, like, it was very difficult for her to cope up with the, like, aftermath of this this radiotherapy. So it was very difficult for her to sustain in this, because she reported, like, we went to, like, there was an emergency on 16th of January. We went to hospital. She was completely on ventilator, and then she recovered and came back.
Okay.
But there was a sudden collapse on 19th of January 2020.
Oh.
And then that was our last day when I saw my mother, and that day she finally passed away. So this is a complete, briefly I mentioned, like, the journey, what I have seen of my mother. So this what is a thing.
Yes, there were many ups and downs in the journey.
Yeah, actually it was there. So mostly if you see the month, from the last few months of 2019.
Yes.
Or what I observe is, like, the oral chemotherapy which was given to her, it deteriorated her health a lot. Before that, she was fine. She could eat. Sometimes she could eat the normal food also, which we used to eat. That's the one thing. But after this chemotherapy started, her health went down drastically. It fell a lot.
Okay.
So this is what is my observation in this thing.
Okay.
Mostly doctor mentioned it because the cells were able to reach till lungs. And then because lungs have a continuous supply of blood, so maybe that is a reason that cells might have migrated throughout the body. This is what is my journey, still looking after my mother. Most of the times I've been to Mumbai hospital. Like, I accompanied, not in the initial years, but later. I was in college. From college also, I used to come, like, stay her along with her for some 5 days, and then going back to my college. Then again in month, during this month when I was free, I stayed with her. So this is what is the journey. That's all. That's all is all from my side.
Okay. So what were the initial symptoms she had?
As I mentioned, that if we see the first time when it was detected, the problem was the bleeding.
Okay.
Because that's what the problem initially, like, we noticed, like, she used to report, tell about the excessive bleeding.
Okay.
Initially it was less, it increased over the time. So this was the only symptom which we were able to detect. And so one more thing, sometimes she used to faint suddenly, without, like, she was, everything was normal, and then she used to faint.
Oh.
We used to think that she, because of the, like, some gas problem she's facing this. So. Yeah.
Okay. So initially it was stage 3.
Yes. This I remember. The doctor mentioned that it has spread. It had spread throughout the wall, and this need to be, yeah, this didn't go to the other side of the part. It was limited to that uterus thing.
Okay. So
but it
so
has overgrown. Overgrown.
Oh. So she didn't had surgery?
No. Doctor was like, surgery is not required.
Okay.
No, surgery could it be done, because it was already overgrown. If we do, the chances are that this may go to the other part. That's why they didn't suggest it for surgery.
Okay. So in total, how many cycles of radio and chemotherapy were given to her?
I mentioned, so this was given in two phases. First phase was in month of November. November, for every week once it was given to her. Then in the month of February, full month, one day chemotherapy, other day radiotherapy. So it continued for 1 month, continuous. They used to go to Tata Memorial Hospital, TMH, up and down. This was being done continuously. One day chemo, other day radiotherapy.
Okay. So any alternative treatment you took, Ayurvedic, homeopathic, during the treatment?
No.
No.
We didn't go for the other treatment.
Any most, life?
We had no idea. Like, whether what to, because this was something very new in my family, and we had no idea and this was only option and hope for us, PMLG.
Okay. So any lifestyle changes you made?
Hello.
Hello. Yes, I can hear you. Hello. Yes. Any lifestyle changes she made? Yes, yes, you're audible.
Pardon?
Yes. Any lifestyle changes she made during the treatment? Doing pranayam or any diet changes?
No, nothing. Yeah, like food habits, very obviously it changed.
Sorry, I can't hear you. Yes, now I can hear you.
Hello?
Yes, hello. Yes.
So only the food habit.
Okay. So what was your first reaction when you found that your mother has cancer?
There was only one thing. That she will be fine. That's all. On the day 19 November 2017, when we got the confirmation from doctor's side that she has cancer, then the only thing which was there in my mind was like, she will be fine. That's okay. The only reaction which I remember and still there in my head.
Okay. And how did she took the shock?
She was like, one thing I want to mention about my mother. She is a, she is a patient who has extreme willpower. Yeah, because in the month of December 2017, because that was my winter vacation, my college, I went and met her. So although she was in bed weak, but she said me one thing, that I will be fine. Don't be bothered. Look, just see forward. That's all she mentioned. And that's the main reason why we were too much positive and confident about her. Extremely. She's a person of extreme willpower.
Okay. So she was motivating you too by her willpower.
Everyone. Not me. Everyone. My father, my sisters, everyone.
Yes.
Her confidence was positivity and hope for us.
Okay. So for you, your mother was a support system, even though when you are a caregiver.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
So, how are you now? How is life going now? Your life?
It's it's very obvious to see things there's an incompleteness. Like in one word, if I want to mention, there's an incompleteness. There's a void which is there and which is permanent, which will remain there. That's all.
So any message you want to give to patients or caregivers on their journey?
Yeah. This only one thing which I want to mention, and that is in 2017 itself, doctor, when I discussed with my father, because most of the thing he didn't disclose. Although I was very much direct to the, sometime I met the doctor, I saw the report, all the reports. But one thing which he never mentioned was in 2017 itself, doctor clearly mentioned that her survival is very much limited. They were uncertain, like whether we are giving the treatment. So we don't know for 6 months or 1 year, not more than 1 year. But she was able to take this for over 1 year, for 2 years. So one thing which I have seen her, that was the extreme willpower and positivity that I will be fine. So one message for the patient, be extremely confident that you will be fine. Because death is not in your hand. To survive is in your hand. So one thing should be there in the patient's mind is to think about, be positive and be confident. Because uncertainty, no one can handle. For the caregiver, give your best, because result is definitely not certain. But one thing is there, you don't know. This may be the last moment with the patient. So make this moment best for your patient. That's all. Don't show, don't give up, don't cry. Never, never ever we cried before her. Never. Although we sometime in the back, in my college, never before her. I was always happy, confident, and used to tell her, you'll be fine. I used to tell her that there will be one day when we'll be going on a walk again, everything will be normal. So extreme positivity, the psychological environment has to be extremely positive through caregiver. You may think that many people are there who are weak. They feel like, fine, what has happened? There is no treatment. Now it's her death is near. No, his or her. Extremely positive environment is what it should be the priority of caregiver. That's what is my message to you, both the. Yes.
We should never lose hope in any situation,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
So, any special memories with your mother you want to share with us?
Yeah, I remember. One thing is there. As I mentioned that I joined an organization, I went into a job. So only one thing was there. She used to tell, like what I remember is, she said me one thing. My responsibilities are not transferred. Even if I'm not there, you are there to handle this family. That's what I remember. It's still there in my head and will be there in my head forever.
Okay. So, hats off to your mother, her willpower. She's an inspiration. And hats off to your positivity too, the way you are taking things in a very positive way.
Yes.
Thank you. It was so nice talking to you and inspiring too. Thank you so much.
Yes. Okay. Thank you, Divya.
Okay. Have a great day. Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.